And I'm joined now by Will Prochaska, who is strategy director at Gambling with Lives. It is a non-profit organisation that helps the families of those families bereaved by gambling-related suicide. Will, your reaction to all of this, as Theo was explaining, the Gambling Commission did consider whether to remove William Hill's licence, gambling licence, but decided not to go down that route.
Yeah, which I'm very disappointed about, I have to say. William Hill have been fined before, and I suspect that they'll be fined again. And the issue at stake here is that this practice is part of the business model of the modern gambling industry. So 90% of the gambling industry's profits, when you take away the National Lottery, come from 5% of customers who are either addicted or at risk of addiction. So paying a fine of £19.2 million, which will sound like a lot of money to you or I, actually isn't very much money in comparison to William Hill's turnover. And it's much cheaper for them to simply pay the fine and then keep doing business as usual than it is to change their entire business model. So I'm quite frustrated, really, that the Gambling Commission hasn't used all of the powers which are available to Andrew Rhodes says that he has the power to remove a gambling operator's license, but they haven't used it again. And it's becoming really frustrating because week after week, we see more gambling operators hurting more people. Behind these numbers, we see lots of numbers, lots of money talked about, but actually behind these numbers are real people. People are being harmed and people are dying because of what the gambling industry are doing. And it's time that the Gambling Commission got serious and put a stop to it.
Yeah, William Hill, for reference, made nearly £1.9 billion in revenue last year. So that's £1.9 billion in revenue versus a £19 million penalty. What would you like to see, Will, from the government's white paper, this review into gambling, which itself has been delayed?
We've been waiting for the white paper for a couple of years now, and it's really disappointing that we've had to wait so long, but we believe that the new Secretary of State at the Department of Culture, Media and Sport, Lucy Fraser, is going to announce the white paper very soon, and we are confident that there are going to be measures in that which will start to reduce the levels of harm. What she desperately needs to announce are things like a ban on all advertising. So at the moment, the gambling industry misleads the public. It will tell you through its advertising. So it's $1.5 billion a year advertising, and it will tell you that it's fun and it's safe and it's social. And it's not these things, it's dangerous, right? The products which they are promoting are really very addictive, so they shouldn't be allowed to promote them. We need to see action to make those products safer, so they need to be slowed down, to be made less addictive, as well as other elements changed in them. We need to see a stop to the gambling industry taking money off people who can't afford to lose it, so we need to see affordability checks implemented. So those are just a range of some of the policies, but we really need them announced, because it seems every week we're getting another fine, and certainly at Gambling with Lives, almost every week we see another family destroyed by a suicide caused by the actions of these companies.
Almost every week?
Almost every week. One week, about 2 weeks ago, we had three new families come to us, which was the first time we've seen that. So in our view, things are getting worse, and I suspect they're going to get worse until the government really starts to take serious action on this.
And what should be the benchmark, the level for removing a gambling licence? Where should that sit, do you think?
Well, I think what William Hill has been shown to do today clearly surpasses it. Exactly where it is, I would let others say. I think multiple transgressions of your licence, such as William Hill's, should be a simple policy to remove a licence. So if you've done it three times, kind of three strikes and you're out, I would suggest would be a sensible approach to this. Or actually even stronger, if you see transgressions as serious as William Hill's, you know, taking £23,000 off somebody in 20 minutes without any checks whether they're okay is simply unacceptable. And that's what they will continue to do. So it's clear to me that this business model won't stop until all of the operators, all of the licensed operators in Great Britain feel like their business will be taken away from them if they don't clean up their act. And today simply doesn't give them that message. It simply says there'll be a small fine, a slap on the wrist, and you can carry on doing what you've been doing for years.
Will Prochaska from Gambling with Lives, thank you very much.
Thank you.